Hello, this is Tommy. Welcome back to Chatomics. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to download the FASTQ files. So let's go back to the main website here. Click download FASTQ files. And you can follow along here, but let's go to the paper. And this is a geo record. And click that. And this is where the raw data deposited. Okay, so this is a ChIP-seq dataset with different transcription factors and also the IgG control. So if you just click one of them, and then you see this SRX number. This is the experiment number. And for the same experiment, you may have multiple different SRR numbers here. So those are the raw actually file formats in GEO. Those are the SRR formats. You have to use a tool to convert the SRR format to FASTQ, okay, which is the raw data format that will be used for aligning them to the genome. Okay, so in reality, you should actually download all of them, three of them, and convert them all to FASTQs and concatenate them into a single file. But for us, for demonstration, it's just too big, so we'll just use one of them, actually. So if we go back to here, so there's actually a tool to download those files automatically. So of course, you can go there and just download manually, but I find this tool called FASTQ DL, or download is a Python tool to download the GEO datasets programmatically. So you can just create a Conda environment and install this tool, okay? And I like this tool because it has this function or arguments that group by experiment. So you can actually concatenate, it will actually concatenate all the SRR files into the same single file for the same experiment or the same sample here, okay? So I walk you through here. And so actually, unfortunately, I couldn't actually install FASTQ DL on my Mac OS. This is probably one of the most frequent problems we all have. Installing the tools, it's actually very hard sometimes for some of the bioinformatics tools. Okay, so but there are other solutions that you can do, right? You can use a Linux machine, for example, Ubuntu, or you can use a Docker container, or you can download the FASTQ files from ENA. Okay, this is actually the easiest way because in ENA, or let's Google if you don't know what ENA is. It's sequence. So this is called European Nucleotide Archive here. So usually for all the data sets in GEO, they also have a copy here, but instead of the SRR format, it has the raw FASTQ format. So you can just usually just search that GSE ID number in here, search, and you will find actually the same actually project here. But if you go here, then you will see it has the raw FASTQ files for you to download. Okay, so you can just click that for the ones that you want, and then you can download the selected files or you can get the download script. So if you go to my page here, so what you can do, so I use the download the script, so it will give you the scripts to how to download them. And then you can use wget, and this is the URL for the FASTQ files. And so if you go to terminal, pwd here, I already downloaded the file here in the FASTQ. So what you do is you copy this command and then you paste here. It's actually 1.1 gigabyte and it takes a while to download the data. So you can just copy paste all of them and download all of them. And just for demonstration purpose, I just change the name of the file to make them a little bit more self-explanatory. So for example, I just changed this fastq.gz file to tads, this to yap, to TEFL and this one to the iggfastq.gz. Okay, let's see whether we have the okay, still taking some time. But anyway, so after you download the FASTQ files, you can use this command called zls-s to look at the content of this zipped FASTQ file. So FASTQ file is just a normal text file, okay? So four lines is for one records, okay? So this is the sequence, and then this is the actual thread score indicating the quality of each base call. So you can click this link here to read more about the FASTQ format in the Wikipedia page, and also understand how this quality scores is represented, okay, using the ASCII-2 code. Okay, so once we have the FASTQ files here, okay, I will just stop it because it's too slow here. Data here and rename them using the move commands here, so you can follow along here. And we can just take a look at one of them, zls, capital S. This actually is very helpful for me, because usually if you have a very long line, it will not wrap. So for example, like you can actually go left and right, so it will not wrap it. So in this case, so again, you have this four lines for each record, for each read, okay? It's single read, single end read ChIP-seq data, okay? So the first thing you can do is you can use the FASTQC to look at the quality of your data. So what you can do, so you can kind of create this new environment and then install the FASTQC program and then using the Bioconda channel, okay, and then you activate that. You can use Conda because I already created that environment. Let me just list off them and do Conda activate reproduce figure. So now I have FASTQC actually in my environment, so I can do that. So what I can do, you can just use FASTQC and give it the FASTQ file. Okay, if you do this, it will actually start analyzing the FASTQ file, and it will generate a HTML file here. And then you can open it and look at the report. So it will tell you, okay, what's the quality? So this is the total number of bases, like 50 bases. I think this is 50 base long for every read. And it will tell you all the, for each base, the average. And essentially just a box plot for the quality score at that base. And as you can see here, they're all pretty high quality, okay? And that's how you do that for one file, FASTQC, but if you need to do the FASTQC for all of them, right? So you have 1, 2, 3, 4 actually files here. So in batch, you can use this for loop. So for FQ, this can be anything, just a name here. So in star FASTQ.gz, star is a wildcard, so anything. So end up with FASTQ.gz, then you can do FASTQC, and now you refer to that variable, the name, start using $FQ and then done. So it would loop over all the FASTQ.gz files and do the FASTQC for you. Okay, actually it's done already. Okay, so it will give you those the HTML files that you can double click and then just look at the FASTQC report. Okay, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video and make sure you subscribe. See you next time.